What does it tell you about the Sixers that when Butler left, you know, the Heat became a much better basketball team and the Sixers couldn't keep up with what they did with him?
Yeah, you know, they acquired Jimmy Butler, and they paid a fair price for him, and then they let him go. It was pretty obvious that he was the guy who was going to put them over the top or not, and to keep him for, you know, less than a season and let him go, it's sort of squat. You know, this is the kind of thing that Sam Hinkie was absolutely against. You know, when you talk about the process, this isn't Sam Hinkie's process, and he's the one who started the thing. He would not have brought in a guy like that and let him go, you know, give up assets and then let him go for nothing. The way the Sixers did, you know, when it was obvious. Now, there was questions about whether he would get along with Joel Embiid and Ben Simmons. I don't care. You know, I mean, I don't want – if you've got Tobias Harris and you pick him over Jimmy Butler because the guys get along with Tobias Harris better, no. That's not how you're going to make your decisions. You've got to make your decisions on what makes us a better basketball team, and everybody else better get in line with it, or you know, we'll have to look to make other deals. So, yeah, you know, I always cringe a little bit when people say, well, you know, criticize the process, because this isn't the process. This is not what Sam Hinkie had in mind, what the Sixers have done with Brian Colangelo and now Elton Brand in charge.
Sean Devaney, longtime NBA writer, joins us this morning on the show after day one of the NBA playoffs. Let's play a little hypothetical here. If Sam Hinkie remained employed until today, how do you project how he would have built the Sixers versus what we see today?
I do think he would have, you know, obviously they'd have Embiid and Simmons, and I do think they would have made a move for a star. I can't say which one, obviously, and he was stingy with his assets. But I do think that the idea all along was to set up the young guys to win, you know, set up the young guys to where they could start to turn the corner, where they get to that, you know, 38 to 41 win stage, and then you make the deal for the star. I can't say who the star would have been, but I think that that they would have been much more cautious about it. They would have been protective of their assets, protective of their young guys, because now, you know, now you don't have the draft picks, you don't have the young guys. You've got maybe a couple guys who are rookies or second year guys who are getting minutes, but you're not really, you know, you're not really building toward the future here. You're kind of just treading water, and I think he would have always avoided that. He would have always had, you know, it's a lot like Danny Ainge in Boston, where he's kept, you know, they've got three drafts. The Celtics have a chance to go to the finals this year, and they still have three first round draft picks this year. That's the kind of thing I think Sam Hinkie would have done.